Up until today, we've been looking at supply chain management as a series of individual operational functions and decisions. Buy it, make it, move it, sell it, service it. You've had the luxury of studying each in a vacuum, but supply chains are in fact chains. Chains in the sense that these individual functions are interconnected and interdependent. This is the key difference between how most corporations viewed operations 30 plus years ago and how successful modern corporations have adopted a more integrated supply chain approach. Integrated. That means companies need to pull their employees and business partners out of their silos and have them develop a cohesive team with a shared set of goals and compatible philosophies. A professional football player and a world-class expert in yoga. Both can have similar values and desires: strength, flexibility, knowledge, and a healthy diet. But does this mean both will have similar workouts, diets, and muscular features? No, of course not. And as both age, each will have to adapt their daily practices to fit the needs of their changing bodies, jobs, and lifestyles. Businesses are no different. They can all have similar values and desires, but what works for one company may not work for another. And what works for one company today may not work for them tomorrow. Modern businesses can't thrive by copying other companies or live according to checklists. They need to develop philosophies that will guide their actions in the ever-evolving world of business. Developing a winning tradition requires that teams operate as cooperative and integrated units. Players on these teams must trust each other. They must understand and accept their individual roles. They must agree upon individual and team goals. And they must strive to continuously improve and stay ahead of competitors who are aiming to beat them every single day. More than that, they need to understand the failure of one is a failure for all. Successful modern supply chains are no different. Common goals, trust, acceptance and understanding of roles, and a commitment to continuous improvement. These are the keys to developing a competitive, modern, integrated supply chain. In the old days, individual business functions were tasked with specific but limited duties. R&D was tasked with innovating. Quality managers had to eliminate defects. Operations needed to be lean, logistics responsive, and depending on the company, one department or another was responsible for making a profit. But today, competitive companies have knocked down these walls. At every level and in every department, they have made each one of these goals everyone's responsibility. Being lean, responsive, innovative, and profitable, while at the same time maintaining a high level of quality. Integrated goals, integrated responsibilities, integrated supply chain management. To be a successful modern supply chain manager, you need to be a philosophical guru, a coach, and a relationship manager. You need to understand the importance of finance, accounting, marketing, and information technology because materials, money, and information are the lifeblood of modern supply chains. That's why I think the most likely candidates to successfully lead modern organizations into the next generation of business are executives that understand how to design and manage integrated supply chains at the global level. Managers of global integrated supply chains. That's what businesses need. That's what the world needs. That's what you need to become.
The indirect and direct impacts of things like climate change, water scarcity, or indeed the availability of food or oil are impacting the production and affordability of the food products in our system. Sustainable supply is critically important to our business. We're on a journey. We know we've got a long way to go, but we've already achieved a lot. And we have a great foundation to build on. It will mean we'll be able to supply things like Big Macs and quarter pounders for our customers for years to come. It's also a fantastic leadership opportunity for our business. McDonald's is a big player, and we're able to leverage our size and scale and influence to bring real positive change to the industry. What's unique about McDonald's is the long-term partnership that we have with our suppliers, which enables them to invest in the future. We know our biggest impacts, and indeed our biggest challenges, are in agriculture. We literally have hundreds of thousands of farmers supplying raw materials into McDonald's. So the challenge is to impact standards of sustainability and sustainability practices on their farms. And that's why we developed McDonald's Agricultural Assurance Program. That's been running for 10 years now. Some of the farmers with the best sustainability practices, we're profiling in our Flagship Farms program and using them to influence others. Animal welfare is one of those areas that perhaps we've been working on for the longest. All of our eggs now are either free range or barn, and we're continuing to do much more.
We have a sustainable sourcing commitment which prioritises key raw materials that we want to address, such as soy, palm oil, wood fibre and beef. Out of all of our commodities globally, beef is our greatest environmental impact. So we've set up a global roundtable to address this issue.
Traditionally, customers don't necessarily believe everything we tell them. That's why external third-party certification is important to us. That builds on the move we made in 2007, when we had all of the coffee we sell in Europe certified by the Rainforest Alliance, or OOTS certified.
We've done a lot of work on packaging already, but now we've pulled it together under a holistic strategy that means that we're going to use as little of it as possible, as much renewable material as we can, and to use only recycled or certified virgin fibre. It also means that we're going to have a greater focus on enabling recycling from the restaurants, and that's going to be a big challenge going forward. We're working along the whole length of our supply chain, not just in agriculture, but also in manufacturing and logistics. We ask our suppliers to complete an environmental scorecard that looks at energy, water, waste, and emissions to air, and ask suppliers to make improvements each year. So it's not just the environmental aspects of sustainability that we look at, it's also the social aspects. And we have a program for employment practices, which all of our suppliers have to comply with. Once our products are made, we then have to get them to the restaurants. And we have to make sure that we store them and transport them in the most sustainable way possible. We're committed to addressing greenhouse gas emissions across our whole business. And in 2007, we measured the carbon footprint of our European supply chain. That work showed us that 75% of our emissions are from agriculture, which is by far the most difficult for us to influence. We've set clear expectations of our suppliers on reductions, and we have a variety of programs in place to do this.
This is a long journey for us. We've been working on it for over a decade. In supply chain, it's all about assuring supply to the restaurants. But wouldn't it be great if one day we could say to our customers, everything you purchase in a McDonald's is sustainably sourced?
A simple tea bag. Every year, consumers use millions of them. All of Unilever's products, including tea bags, go on a journey before and after they are enjoyed by our consumers. We call this the value chain. It works like this. First, we get the raw materials. Then we make them into a product and deliver it to a shop. Then our consumers buy it, use it, and eventually throw it away. But each step in the value chain also has an impact on the environment. Here at Unilever, we want to reduce that impact and grow our business at the same time. The value chain lets us see where our biggest impacts are, so that we can focus our efforts. So for example, Unilever's hundreds of factories only add up to 3% of our total greenhouse gas footprint. Around 26% of our impact comes from suppliers when they produce raw materials, and around 68% comes from the millions of consumers when they enjoy our products. So, most of Unilever's impacts aren't our problem, right? Wrong. We want to reduce the impact of our products before they enter and after they have left our factories. We work as a team with our suppliers, customers, and our consumers to reduce the impact of our products. We have ambitious plans to grow our business, but growth at any cost is not an option. We want to work to help consumers enjoy our products and cut the environmental impact at the same time. Every day, thousands of suppliers help us make our products, and 2 billion people use them. The maths is pretty simple. If we get ourselves, each of our suppliers, customers and consumers, to be a little more sustainable, these small actions will add up to a big difference. A really, really big difference.